give you my top five pieces of technology and a little bit of tech trends that I thought were the best of the past 12 months. Let's go ahead and get started. So I want to say these are all products that I use personally. The company reviewed a ton of stuff. I didn't include anything on my list that I didn't get a chance to use and test myself. Coming in at number five, perhaps with a bit of a surprise, drop cam. Let me give you the backstory here. There are a ton of web-enabled cameras. This is going back towards the very beginning of the year. Our offices had a bit of a security scare, and I wanted to try and up our security. The folks at Drop Cam reached out, and I figured, you know what, we'll try it. I had really low expectations, and the camera ended up being absolutely awesome. The UI is really easy to use. It's always streaming. It's got a DVR in the cloud. Notifications whenever there's movement was really helpful for a peace of mind. And then they released an HD version, which made the already pretty solid quality look even better. So I loved Drop Cam. It's a small piece of technology. It's not very expensive. You know, about between $100 and $150 to $200. That I really loved and has become invaluable. I've got one now in my son Nathan's nursery, so when I'm at work, I can log in and just, you know, check on it, make sure everything's okay. Coming in at number four, something that initially I did not think was gonna be on my list at all. This is the PlayStation 4. I have never really been a PlayStation person. I never liked playing on the console because I didn't like the controller all that much. I always thought it was the best value of the consoles out there because you've got a ton, especially in the PS3, Xbox 360 era. You know, you've got a really awesome Blu-ray player, and of course, all the media capabilities, but the PS4 has changed my mind. I really enjoy it. I'm not just using it for games. I use it for all my streaming now. I haven't even touched my Apple TV since I got the PS4. I love it, and I'm excited that it's got a place in my component standard for probably the next close to decade. PS4 has been awesome for me. Number three, the new iPads. Whether you're an iPad Air or an iPad Mini with Retina display, the new iPads definitely have a place in my heart. I prefer the Mini iPads. I really love the original iPad Mini. Now they upped the specs. They're pretty much put it on par with the big size iPads. Get Retina display has been awesome for me. If you like the bigger size, of course, the iPad Air, things super, super thin, thin bezels, and a really light design. I think Apple knocked this generation iPads out of the park. From the software side, that's a whole other discussion, but hardware, I absolutely love the iPads. Next, coming in at number two, the Moto X. First, I think this says a lot. Two people in our office, one of our main mobile writers, Brandon Russell, and our managing editor, Roy Choi, carry Moto X's with them with access to pretty much every single phone. I love the fact that you can customize every aspect of it. First time we've really seen that, at least every physical aspect of it. I like the fact it's made in the United States. I really like it's gotten Google updates very, very quickly, almost as fast as Nexus devices. I like the notifications it's got on there. Really, everything about the phone is nice. It might not have cutting-edge specs, but the experience is really good, and I think that's what matters most. And number one, Google Play phones. This was something that really nobody saw coming. Essentially, all the flagship phones of the year pretty much got stock Android edition loves. I was debating about whether or not putting the HTC One at my number one spot or making a Google Play phones, but it turns out I really liked the HTC One Google Play edition. I really liked the Galaxy S4 Google Play edition, the new phones that just came out, the Xperia, you know, the giant Xperia Z, or I guess it's just called Sony Z. When I got Google Played up, I really love that Google is doing this. They're contract-free, relatively expensive devices. You don't have to sign any 2 years of your life away or worry about, you know, upgrade plans or when you can upgrade or pay it off over months. You get stock Android, you get really quick upgrades. I really like that Google is doing this. I hope this trend that continues. We're seeing it sort of branch into tablets now with the LG G Pad, and I think it's a really cool trend. And it's one of my favorite things to see. I love seeing how technology has been evolving, how consumers are becoming first. I think the Google Play Edition devices are really a keen example of that. There are obviously a ton of other devices that I could have included. It's really hard to pare down the top five. But for me, these are the top five that I really enjoyed the most, that I thought did something cool for my life, or that represented sort of a new trend in the industry. I'd love to hear what your guys' top fives are. If you want to leave them down below in my pants region. And take a minute to thank our friends and sponsors at Netflix. They're the best way to stream content. You can do it on pretty much every single device you've got, whether you've got an Apple TV, a game console. You can get Netflix anywhere you are. They've got awesome original content, Orange Is the New Black, House of Cards, and a lot of other cool stuff coming. So be sure to check them out. Go to netflix.com/buffalo for your free 30-day trial. Again, that's netflix.com/buffalo. Thank you guys for watching. Please give the video a thumbs up. We'll definitely appreciate it. And I wish you guys a very happy, healthy new year. And may your worst day of 2014 be your best day of 2013. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. What's up, everyone? John here. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, I certainly hope you did. Click on the subscribe button right under me in my pants region to get tons more tech videos from Techno Buffalo. We've got awesome unboxings, comparisons, reviews, recaps, and everything else you can think of in the tech world right here on the channel. Join the herd today! If you want to check out some more content, just click right over this way to see some other recent videos. See you guys next time.